your cares.
Call your cares.
About me.
About me.
Me. Me.
For over half a century, the Collier Center for Communication Disorders at the University of Texas at Dallas
has been dedicated to transforming
the lives of children and adults with speech, language, and hearing disorders.
That's a long time.
That's forever.
Collier's vision is to be the national leader for
treatment,
training,
and research in communication disorders.
Wow.
Did you know that Collier
provides more than 48,000 clinical services
to 4,000 children and adults a year?
Oh my goodness!
Wow!
What kind of services?
Hearing aids.
The cochlear implant program.
Speech and language therapy.
Autism spectrum disorder.
That's a mouthful.
Collier focuses on abilities,
not disabilities.
Anyone with a speech, language, or hearing disorder
can enjoy a positive and productive life
at home, at work, and at play.
About 7%
of the U.S. population has a speech disorder.
When we talk about speech disorders in general, we've got some big categories. People are familiar with patients who have had a stroke and have apraxia of speech, so they have a very difficult time forming the sounds for speech.
My voice.
The same is true for children, but it's developmental, so they've never had speech. Then we have the other, and that's called dysarthria. And what that is weakness and the inability to form sounds and words because of the way the muscles are functioning and the way the brain is talking to the muscles and making those connections. Children with a motor speech disorder aren't just trying to produce language and communicate. They're having a really hard time producing the actual sounds.
Caroline, when she was born, she had a stroke in utero and developed hydrocephalus, which is the water on the brain. And they said that, you know, if Caroline were to live, she would not eat, hear, talk, basically just be a vegetable. I remember just sitting by her little bed in the hospital, she was 3 days old, and just was like, no, that is not gonna happen.
For a child like Caroline who has dysarthria, what we're trying to do is help her figure out how to plan movements, how to make her mouth work. There's a lot of cueing that we use, a lot of telling her where to put her tongue, telling her where to put her lips, how to, you know, break up the two-syllable word into much more manageable pieces. It is!
We first came to Collier, and I were to see Caroline now, I think I would be blown away with her speech and how far she's come.
I have a happy heart.
You have a happy heart.
Yeah. I can't put into words how much Collier has helped Caroline and our family and the tools that she leaves with to go out into school that she really does carry with her are just invaluable.
A very important part of the therapy is feedback, but we do have some limitations in this treatment. For example, one of the most important parts of our body for making speech is the tongue. In fact, it's the most important part of the body. But we cannot really give people help with this part of the body because it's inside our mouth. That's why we've developed this new procedure called OptiSpeech.
Basically, what we have is we have a 3D model of a human head, and then all of the internal components of the mouth, there are teeth and tongues and gums and all of that stuff. And we have these motion sensors that are attached to subjects' tongues, and the movement from those sensors is then translated to virtual markers that allow this 3D geometry to move in real time.
Buttercup.
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 Instant feedback is the key of this system. By showing them what we call the place of articulation, that is where the tongue goes in the mouth, touching the roof of the mouth, or being high or low for different vowels, we can help guide them to better productions.
With this technology, we're actually able to spin the virtual camera around it in three dimensions. You can look at it from any angle, from the back, from the front, from the side. It's a little bit like a golfer that uses a similar kind of technology where they can video themselves and watch themselves and analyze their swing in a way to improve it.
We have this opportunity to bring together engineers, graphical artists, top scientists, and linguists to make these breakthroughs. It's cutting edge stuff.
Millions of Americans
suffer from chronic ringing in the ears
known as tinnitus. I'm in tinnitus.
Tinnitus is the perception of a continuous sound, but sound that's not generated by some external sound.
Tinnitus is actually a phenomenon of the brain, and it's a symptom of hearing loss or other conditions.
So what does tinnitus sound like? Now, imagine that going on for every waking minute of your life.
We can go back to the Middle Ages where people cut off their ears to try to get rid of tinnitus. I mean, Van Gogh did that.
Think about holding down a job when you have tinnitus in the background and being able to communicate with others while this sound is constantly being there.
It's generally not as simple as I have ringing in my ears. Some patients have musical sensations in their ears where they actually hear melodies or actual full symphonies in their ears.
The way it's affecting me is
I noticed I had was an echo in my ear. And I had gone to 3 different ENTs and nobody could tell me what it was.
A lot of people thought there was other things going on, and nobody gave her a diagnosis and nobody even tried different treatments with her.
You know, if somebody says a sentence, it's one long noise. You know, I can hear that they're saying something, but I can't make out the words because echo is overlapping, you know, from one word to the other one. You're talking to someone and you have no idea what they're saying.
So when she came to us, we used a combination of proper hearing aid fitting to help her auditory deprivation. And we also set up something called a Zen program, which is sound therapy. It produces a musical tone in the background that helps her distract her from the sensation that her own head's producing.
The hearing aids I have now, you can just concentrate at one spot and I have a program that lets me just focus on whoever is speaking and so on, cut out the background noise, and I can hear and understand them.
The research project that we're involved in at the University of Texas at Dallas, as well as our partners over at UT Southwestern, is a treatment approach that is aimed at eliminating tinnitus. So not just make it better, but make it go away.
The other treatments at the moment only give symptomatic relief. Basic idea is that we're going to stimulate the vagal nerve with an electrode. This is the electrode. And we're going to stimulate this with an IPG, an internal pulse generator,
that will be surgically implanted.
But also pairing the electrical stimulation with auditory tones, or you know, tones that you hear, that will change how the auditory areas in the brain are reacting to the tinnitus.
So we're really privileged that the Callier Center is involved in this clinical trial because it's an FDA-approved clinical trial and we are only one of the 4 sites in the world that are doing this trial.
A project like this, and for us to carry it out and have a successful outcome, can impact millions of people across the world.
Thank you for supporting the Callier Center.
Gracias, Callier.
Thank you for making a difference in my life.
Thank you for helping me.
Thank you for giving me hope.
Thank you.
Thank you for our cochlear implants.
Because of you, I can talk.
Because of you, I can hear.
Thank you.
I love you.
You are the best.
You rock.